Today, I'm going to look at the contractor locking out kit from Ideal Industries. Anyone who's been following the channel for some time will know I love a pouch, and in front of me I have Ideal Industries locking off kit in this pouch here. Super important for electricians as well as people training to be an electrician that they have a locking off kit. So we're going to see what's in this one today. So as I open it up, the first thing I want to point out to you is the padlock, and there's a message on the box, which will obviously get thrown away, that says to record the key number somewhere. So when we pull it open, the keys themselves have a unique number on them, and it's important we write that somewhere else in the event of maybe locking off a circuit on site and the keys become misplaced. At least with the number, we'll be able to get a replacement set cut. So that's the locking off kit, as well as the other bits that are within the actual set itself. So as we get these out onto the desk, we can see them all laid out down here. I like the nice touch. They give you a permanent marker pen for your tags, so you can fill in the details on the back. It's a really good idea. As well as differing sets of actual the ability to lock off either switches or breakers. The two I'm going to concentrate on today are these two here, the pins out device, as well as the universal MCB locking out device. And they look like this. So I'm seeing those in action rather than these larger ones that are designed for more industrial or larger switches. So if we go first of all for the pins out device, I've got a board here. I've isolated the circuit. I've got my pins out device, I'm pushing it up, and I'm just going to lock it into the two holes either side of the circuit breaker. Push it fully back into position. That allows the hole in the top to be fully open, allowing you to put the padlock through. The key for the padlock, open it up. We're also going to put a sign in place, warning the person or persons in the installation about the isolation procedure. Details on the back with that permanent pen. And then it's a simple case of putting the two together, passing it through the hole in order we can secure the isolation, leaving the tag for visual display. And as always, once it's locked, we need to make sure that we keep hold of the keys themselves. So there it is, that's the pins out one. Simple idea. There's two holes above a lot of the circuit breakers that are manufactured in order that we can push those pins out into position, fully push it back into place, and then lock off the actual device itself. We can also, with that one, include the hasp, so we can have a multi-lock in position, so it's not just down to that one lock. So I showed it with one lock to start with, but I could have put the hasp in, meaning a maximum six people could be in control of that circuit, in order that all six of you have to agree, remove your padlock before obviously the circuit can be re-energized. That's a really good idea. We also said we'd look at the universal MCB locking off. So we've got our universal device, which has a very small grub screw in it. Always ideal to leave it wound down when finished. So at the moment it's in the down position. I'm going to wind that one back up. And that's going to go over the top of the breaker which we isolate. Choose a separate breaker, different from the first one. Push it snugly into position, make sure it fits perfectly before tightening up the screw. The screw will now go down into the soft plastic, firm but not overly tight. You don't want to damage the breaker. So firmly into position. And then we're going to go for the same process again. Checked it's isolated. Get our padlock. Undo our padlock with our key. That goes through the hole on the top. We're going to put a sign on it as we did before, so the person knows, or the people in the installation know, that the circuit has been isolated. Maybe you fill the details in the back as well. Slip it over, lock it back off, so we secure the isolation of the circuit, and we keep the keys again ourselves. We could have done it exactly the same from the point of view. We could have used the hasp. So if we look here, we could have inserted the hasp through the same universal MCB lockout device and therefore had more than one padlock in place. Simple. I like simple ideas. Easy to use, so there's no barrier to it, so we can easily clip it on, whether it be the universal or the pins out device, in order to secure, in this case, a circuit breaker in the off position. We'd obviously go through the safe isolation procedure at the other end. If it was the wrong circuit, obviously we'd have to unattach it and move it to a different circuit, etc. All stuff that we're familiar with in the electrical industry. The same device, the pins out device, can be used on behind me on the main switch of the contact and board behind me. So let's have a look at that next. So once again, make sure all circuits are isolated. You wouldn't want to throw the switch on full load. Any of the positions you could have poked it through. So we put the two pins in, pins out into any of the holes. I chose the 1/3 in. Exactly the same process. Locking off kit goes through. We could have used the hasp, but I didn't this time. I just used the individual one in order to lock it off. So there we go. We've demonstrated a few different ways in which we could use those. There are other devices, I said, in the kit, these larger ones here for weather throw. In other words, the main switch may be a lot longer or a circuit breaker is a lot longer in order that we can go on and clamp down onto those. And it works in a similar way. It prevents it from being pushed back into the on position. We've also got an isolator down here. Allows us to use either just the padlock on its own or the hasp in order to isolate that. Let's have a look at that next. So we've got an isolator here. It's on the on position. Rotate it to the off. If we rotate it further, it goes into what's called the locking position and opens up two possible locking areas. I'll take a padlock and my sign as always. I push it through and I can choose either of the two positions in order to lock it off. Slide it through and simply lock it back off and keep the key as always. And that would be secured in one position. You could secure it in a second position. So if you bought yourself another padlock, you could repeat the process again. So two people now could have control. So two electrical contractors on the same installation can have control over re-energisation of that circuit. And as before, we could have used a hasp and therefore have more than one person in control. So we could have up to a maximum, therefore, of six people in control again of that isolator there by using the hasp. I think the Ideal Industries locking off kit is a really good investment. I think it covers all the devices that you're going to come across on a regular basis in the electrical industry. And we've shown two of those real common ones where we've looked at the circuit breaker and a main switch. We've also used just the locking off of the padlock and the hasp in order to do an isolator. We've got these other larger ones that will get you out of trouble when you've got those larger devices, maybe in a more industrial environment. As always, me and the team at eFIXX are interested in your opinion. Are you currently using the contractor lockout kit from Ideal Industries? Are you thinking about using it in the future? Which is your go-to locking off kit? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.